There's only one real French drain designed by Mr. French. What he did was dug out a trench. He leaves a gap at the end of the pipe. The pipe runs right along the top of the footer. The footer is level. There is no pitch. He put stone in there that's larger than the gap. It's not about the pipe. A true drainage system is about the trench. Trench has got to be wide enough to give the water into the trench and rise up into the trench. On Mr. French's drain, it would rise up and it would get in those openings and the water would have a clear path to run to a sump pump. You got to put the concrete floor back. Concrete floor has to sit on something, so it's got to sit on stone. Water gets into the trench, rises up in the trench, gets into the pipe. All the pipe is a void in the stone, which allows water to pass through rapidly. Down in Washington, D.C., no building can be built any higher than the Washington Monument. Everybody built below grade. There was so much water, Mr. French's drain wasn't working. Who are you going to call in Washington, D.C. to fix the problem? You call the United States Army Corps of Engineers. That's the system that I install. ADS pipe is designed to replace clay pipe. United States Army Corps of Engineers designed it. There's nothing better. It worked then, it works now. Washington, D.C. would be completely underwater if not for the kind of system I install.
There's really no such thing as a French drain anymore. It is a pressure relief system.
The trench needs to be 10 inches beyond the footer, dug to the bottom of the footer. We've just dug out this little section. I got all this water coming in from outside. All of this water is outside pushing on this wall, lateral pressure. If you dig your trench to the bottom of the footer and you put your pipe down at the bottom of the footer, there isn't going to be any water. The pipe will be in this trench surrounded by stone. The pipe creates a void in the stone. Water rises up, gets right into the pipe, and it creates a void for the water to flow rapidly to the pumps. This is what's called fibrous filter paper. See the dirt buildup in it? It's clogging the filter. It's not allowing the water to get through. Anyone who owns an automobile, your oil filter, gas filter, air filter, they get clogged. Those filters have to be changed out. You can't come in and break up the concrete to change out a filter in one of these systems when it gets clogged. This is where they put their pipe. We dug out the trench where it's supposed to be, and there's where the water is. This trench should be 10 inches beyond the footer, which is double the amount of work. This contractor wants to cut corners and get the job done in half the time. Well, he just does half the work. This trench has to go down to the bottom of the footer here, and the trench has to be dug this wide. This is the box system on top of the footer. There's the water. When it does rain, this water rises all the way up to here, and this concrete will be wet or damp below any carpet before it can even get to where the box system is on top of this footer. Water down here, box system up there. This is the width of the trench that was put in. It's about this wide. They didn't go wide enough. They did not go deep enough. This is where they installed their pipe. Down here is where the water is. There's the water down there. There's the box system up there. This is designed so that the water is supposed to go into here. How's it supposed to get into there?
Doesn't look like it works very well to me.
This is the PVC pipe here. There's the water. This is the width of their trench right here. It needs to be this much wider. Down here is where the water is. Everyone thought this building can't be fixed. Let me show you why. This is a false floor. Can you see this concrete down here? This was the original floor. They put a layer of cinder in here, and then they put another floor over the top of it. This is a long way to dig for your common contractor. I've got this dug down to the bottom of the footer. Once I get the pumps in here and the crops, they're going to be below this. All this water is going to drain. This place will never have a problem. Get the weep holes in there, we'll drain the walls, get the system in here, and we'll be out of here. And sometimes jobs are not easy. You got to go the extra mile. This is where the system needs to be.
Weep holes have to be drilled into every cell of every block and every mortar joint. As I drill each cell, the water comes out. But the water also comes out of mortar joints where the two blocks come together. The holes are not to the bottom of the block because the bottom of the block can be solid. When you're drilling, you might hit a solid area. You have to stop drilling and raise the drill until the water does come out.
Gee, I just can't understand why I might have water in my basement.
That comes out of this wall. If the weep holes were done properly, there would be no water in this wall.
That's not cinder block anymore.
What is it?
Your blocks are rotted.
This is cinder, which once upon a time was a cinder block.
The weep balls just were not put in properly, and you had continuous rot, and this is what happens when mortar sits at the bottom of blocks for too long.
That's above grade, and this is below grade.
No weep hole on the mortar joint.
They missed this one. They missed this one.
No weep hole in this mortar joint.
They did not drill out every cell of every block, nor did they drill out the
mortar joints. Have not been drilled out.
No weep holes where I just took the system apart.
When you're talking about a pressure relief system, every weep hole has to be drilled, especially when you've got a wall that's moving.
No weep hole in the mortar joint. Nothing here. Nothing here.
They got weep holes in here.
Oops, they missed the mortar joints.
Right here's the mortar joint. Water can accumulate in there. And then one of these holes is above it. So if you don't drill this out, that water can build all the way up. We getting on the same page yet?
This is a magic wand. I will sell you this magic wand for $1,500 plus shipping. But what you do is you take this magic wand and you tap the wall 3 times. Click your heels once. Close your eyes and repeat after me. In the name of Hydroarmor, abracadabra, water be gone.
That may sound a little bit silly.
Well, if you believe PVC pipe or a box system is going to solve the problem, you might as well believe in the magic wand. And if you believe in the magic wand and you send me $1,500 plus 50 plus shipping, you will only throw away $1,700. Because whatever you pay for a PVC system or whatever you pay for a box system, you're just throwing that money away.
They haven't even gotten into this job, and I can see that they used a 6-inch piece of mirror drain. They've got 2 inches on the bottom and 4 inches up.
The mirror drain is straight up and down. See how it's straight up and down? You see how the drip knot is installed properly?
It looks like the job was done properly, but this is not. This is the type of piping that was installed. This is the type of pipe the company who did this job told the customer they were getting.
When the salesman is in your house, he shows you a certain kind of pipe. This is not what he showed you.
Some of these guys tell you this PVC pipe with this black liner, which is an antimicrobial liner. No mold will grow in it. Mold doesn't grow on plastic.
What do you got? 3/4 of an inch?
About 1/3 of the concrete needed. 1/3 of the work, 1/3 of the cost. That's how you low bid.
I'm not saying anything. Okay. This is where they've stopped the pipe right here, and this is where they've stopped the pipe over here. How can this possibly be a continuous system? Where's the water supposed to flow? The trench was deeper the way it's supposed to be. You'd be able to go underneath this and get a proper flow. Any kind of piping needs to have a way to get into the pump. There's no pipe entering this crop from anywhere.
Get that down in here.
That's the end of the pipe. What the hell is that? The water is not getting into the system fast enough, into the crock fast enough, and getting pumped out fast enough. It's still building up, and the wall is continually being pushed in.
There's supposed to be piping going into this crock. Where is it?
I don't see it.
There's a PVC pipe. How's it supposed to get into that crock?
Contractor will cut corners by using inferior products or components, cutting corners, cutting corners, cutting corners. The company that did this job will not warranty it because they say they don't have a wall warranty. If they did the job properly in the first place, this will not happen. There is one place PVC pipe belongs.
There's the water. The footer is level. The trench is level. The pipe to the bottom of the trench, level. Stone around it, it creates an air void for water at the bottom of the trench to flow rapidly. No pitch, no water. Well, that looks pretty.
And so ends another day.
This is a sump pump crock setup.
Now this is a Zoller 1/3 horsepower pump.
1/3 Zoller will pump out 44 gallons per minute.
Been using Zoller pumps for 30 years now. I have never had to replace one. This is a hydro pressure pump. That work off your water pressure.
You can see the Zoller and the hydro pressure pump. This is going to be the water line. These are PEX piping. And this will be the water line that's going in. This here is a seal. Goes around the top.
This is a pressure valve. When the backup pumps go on, water flows. This is spring loaded. When the water stops, it slams shut. So no bacteria can backflow
valve into the drinking water. This is a shutoff valve. Any problem with the pumps, you just shut the water off right here. Water line comes down, it goes into this hydro pressure pump. Down below you have your Zola pump. This is a rubber seal, so when that lid is put back, bolted down, it's sealed. The water pressure is 80 pounds. The hose is turned on full blast.
Right now I'm holding the float down to the hydro pressure pump so it does not come on.
My water pressure is still on,
and when I release the hydro pressure pump, listen to how quiet it is. Can't even hear it. This is it going off. So the water is dropping. I'm still on full pressure here because the hydro pump is pumping it out.
Oh, how we do love this modern technology.
Okay.
Any mold spore that can survive that deserves to live.
The entire building has been sprayed down with a mold detergent, killing all the existing mold, and the mold has been cleaned off. The paint is a microbial sealant. If you have finished wall with insulation in it, you've got heat here, and then you have a cold wall condensation can build up on. This is Thermalarm. It's rated R15 insulation factor. This is the next step after waterproofing a basement if you intend on finishing the basement. It's hermetically sealed at the bottom. Every seam, every pipe, board, hermetically sealed. No vapor can get through this at all. The top is not sealed so that it breathes. This is the best thing to do if you intend on finishing a basement after waterproofing.